Let's go. All right, these are a little high. There's the line right there. There's a line right there. Eight rounds, touch them up. Good luck. Come out at the bell.
You heard Pat Russell. It's scheduled for eight. Mariano Hilario, you see him there. He said, listen, the challenge for me tonight is to show everyone I'm here to fight and prove myself. A win tonight would do wonders for my career. Ahmed Elbiali. He's basically knocked out everyone he's faced. He said, I want to show people I can actually box and go some rounds. This is round one. Elbiali in the red, gold, and black trunks. Hilario in the black trunks, the red and blue trim. Here's a left hook by Elbiali.
I wonder how much Hilario warmed up in the dressing room. He looks bone dry right now.
He has no perspiration or nothing on him at all.
Neither does Elbiali, really.
Yeah, you're right about that. There's the jab.
But he looks warmed up. You know, a lot of times probably he'll towel you off and then the wait period. But Hilario doesn't look like he did anything. Maybe but just shadow boxed a little bit.
Elbiali coming out aggressive because you can see the mean intention on his when he throws those punches.
Don't do that. Hilario looking to survive and sneak something in. You can tell he's got great focus. Five furrows in his forehead. That lets you know he's concentrating to the T. He doesn't want to get even one of these big bombs that's coming at him.
The hooks. Elbiali just missed. Here's another right hook he just missed with. Elbiali, again, is originally from Egypt. Moved here when he was four. Moved to the Miami area. That got his degree. FIU. Now in the MBA program.
Always good to have something to fall back on after boxing.
Nice right hand.
There's another right hand by Elbiali.
Hilario's game, though, man, you know?
Stop, come here. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Left hook to the body by Elbiali. Another left to the body. We're under a minute here in round one.
I like that Elbiali has the thought process to go to the body. Usually these big punchers looking for these end up becoming really headhunters because they know they can hurt you to the head so badly. But Elbiali, we're here in round one, and maybe the headshots haven't gotten a knockdown, so he's thought to go to the body right away.
He said that left hook is his favorite punch.
And you can see that his right hand hasn't developed like the hook yet. And one thing about him throwing his right hand, he's leaving himself open for a counter hook from Hilario because he's cocking the right hand every time he gets close.
Elbiali getting more and more aggressive. Hilario's going to have to come with some counter shots as the fight progresses. He's going to last. He's got to make Elbiali doubt that offense that he throws.
Hilario took this fight on 2 weeks' notice. Told us his right cross will be the key in this fight.
Break. Now go. Listen for the bell.
Round one's in the books. This is Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Round two when we come back. Welcome back. Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. In our main event, this man right here, Gerald Washington, undefeated, 16-0. He's got 11 by knockout. Takes a big step up in competition when he takes on Amir Mansour. It's our main event. It's coming up here on the PBC on FS1. In the meantime, this is round two. Ahmed Elbiali taking on Mariano Hilario.
Right there. Hilario.
Hilario trying to throw the big guns out. Loading
yes,
up that right hand.
And it's good to see he's got a good sweat going now.
Nice body shots again.
Body shots by Elbiali.
Again, Paulie, as he goes up the ladder, he's going to have to correct the right hand. He cocks it, he telegraphs it, and he leaves himself open. But his left hook is a thing of beauty.
Don't forget, fans, we told you at the top of the broadcast, we're going to let you help us score the fights tonight. Just go to throwdownscoring.com. Score the fights. We'll put your scorecards up throughout the broadcast.
To stop cutting the range behind that jab, too.
Yeah.
Hilario is giving him a lot of movement. Elbiali's trying to cut range with just power shots.
That's the danger of hitting everybody and they fall. One night you show up and the guy doesn't fall. You get confused, you leave yourself open, he starts touching you back. And then you realize you still have to go to the drawing board if you're going to improve as a fighter. Nice uppercut.
Yeah, there's an uppercut there by Hilario.
And that was because Elbiali didn't snap out that jab. They kind of put it out there lazily.
Well, he's not using a jab hardly at all. He's just coming in with the big left hook, tucking in and ducking down. He's telegraphing everything he does, even though he's got a good shot in there.
Yeah, there's a right hook that connect back to Hilario up.
Hilario's a stubborn one.
Let him out. Okay, stick a step.
Hilario was stopped in his last fight in May. He was stopped in the eighth round, but before that, he won six straight fights.
If you watch, Paulie, he ducks 90% of the time when he gets into his opponent.
Yeah.
So he telegraphs what he's going to do.
Under a minute here in round two, Elbiali said he wanted to dedicate this fight to his father, who underwent 11 hours of brain surgery in June. Wow. Now taking radiation treatments. Said he's watching at home in Miami.
Good shot.
Let go. Hilario. Play inside. All right, whoa, let
us
hit out. Let it out. There you go.
Oh. Protect yourself at all times.
Elbiali was good sport to not throw that shot. Yeah. He could have thrown that hook there.
He had every right to.
Stop. Heads. Listen for the bell.
As I was saying earlier, Elbiali is telegraphing everything he does with the right hand. He telegraphs it there, he comes back with a hook. Hilario's seeing everything he does. He'll come back with one more that he cocks back and telegraphs. Not working behind his jab. He needs to work behind the jab a little bit more.
So that right hand is looping it all the time. Sometimes, just like Michael Hunter found out last fight, when you throw it straight, sometimes you penetrate the guard a little bit better.
This is round three. Elbiali comes right out. And he's won his last two fights by first round knockout. Last time he's gone the distance was March earlier this year. He won a unanimous decision against Mike Stafford. In sixth round, there's a right hand by Hilario. Followed it up with an uppercut.
Again, that's the danger, just coming in reckless and thinking everybody you hit's gonna fall. There's the second right hand that lands over his lazy left. And now he's thinking he's gonna try to knock the wall. He's gonna try to knock the tree down with a dull axe.
You know, here's the thing. If he's gonna keep looping that right hand, he's gotta come back with a hook to the body or something. You know, because he's putting himself in a position to throw the hook to the body if he's gonna loop the right hand like that. A lot like Cotto and Canelo actually set up their left hooks to the body.
Exactly.
Talk about left hooks. There's a couple of left hooks by Elbiali and followed up with an uppercut.
Right, I gotta stop. Watch your heads. Head out.
I wonder if Elbiali is a natural southpaw and they turned him around. He's sort of fighting that way, Paulie.
Yeah.
There's a right hand.
And that one he threw a little bit straighter.
He threw it a lot straighter.
So you go back to your fundamentals, man. Some miracles happen sometimes.
Well, if you got a lethal left hook, you'd like to see a jab working good.
Yeah, but he's not landing that looping right. I mean, that right hand just landed when he threw it straight. I'd like to see him keep that right hand straight.
Hilario didn't come to lay down, that's for sure.
Well, he said, listen, I got to outbox him. I know that. He said he was motivated a lot by Javier Fortuna, his countryman. He said when he won the title, he had him motivated.
That was a good right to the body by Hilario.
Stop. Break. Step out.
A good test for Elbiali.
Here's the left hook.
Also, you get to see Elbiali's conditioning if this fight goes rounds, and we'll see how he maintains that kind of firepower he's showing us in the early rounds.
Stop.
See if he
stop.
feet stays with the, in the late rounds.
No more.
Already, Pauly, he's stopping his feet before he punches. When Hilario goes against the ropes, he'll do it right here. He'll stop his feet. He didn't do it that time, but he's really starting to show that he's looking for nothing but the home run.
Punches up.
He has to be careful that he doesn't run into something.
Listen for the bell. Stop. Stop. Listen for that bell.
We talked about last round how Elbiali was starting to take some right hands from Hilario, and there's one followed by actually a clash of heads. And there's one of the right hands early on in the round. And then later in the round, as Elbiali throws these loopy shots, there's another shot. This one kind of grazed and didn't land as clean as the first one, but he took another overhand right from Hilario. Hilario standing tough. He's stubborn in there.
This is round four. It's scheduled for eight, and there's a stiff jab by Hilario.
Elbiali walked right across the ring and started throwing left hooks. He's going to have the patience to set this power up, especially against this kind of opponent.
Well, nice combination by Hilario.
I think, see, now he's getting picked off from the distance because he's not jabbing.
He's not jabbing and he's stopping his feet. And he's just cocking everything he's throwing. Hilario looked more confident going back to his corner the last round. Now he's got a little smile on his face. I think he's taking some of the biggest punches. Maybe he feels like Elbiali's punches, the intensity is going down.
But when you also have a guy who doesn't throw a jab, you should be using your jab yourself. And Hilario doesn't do that even at a distance. He's starting to land some shots here on Elbiali and showing us some, maybe some flaws in the armor that Elbiali has. But at the same time, right here, Hilario should be the one jabbing. If Elbiali's not going to jab, then you should be jabbing at him.
Good call there. He really should.
These guys fight on the inside here and against the ropes.
The concern is he's starting to hit Elbiali with two pieces. He's starting to put the punches together, so he's feeling confident. I think he feels that the intensity is dying.
Right, take a step.
Well, we asked you at the top, give us some of your scorecards. We got some of them in. Let's take a look at one of them. You got Elbiali winning all three rounds thus far.
I got it. Stop. Step back.
Again, right here, the guy that jabs first here could start taking control of the tempo when it's at center ring. Neither guy really being busy with the jab. Here's another opportunity. Let's see. Waiting. Power shots.
Inside of a minute here in round four.
Elbiati has to be careful, Paul. When he's coming to Hilario now, you watch. When he comes to Hilario, he slows up his pace. And he starts fainting with his whole body, but his legs are stationary. He's wide open for combination punching now. He's done it three times in a row. He's looking to plant and hit right there, right there. That's what I'm talking about. He's telegraphing everything he's doing by ducking, planting his feet and ducking, so he's telegraphing.
Let it go. Let the hands go.
A good
stop.
Jab to start turning this fight around for Hilario.
Final seconds here, round four. They both cock right hand. Elbiali, a combination, and a takedown by Hilario.
Come here. Go start your gloves. All right, now go back.
And don't forget, coming up, it is our main event. Gerald Washington taking on Amir Mansour. And so just one defeat at 6'1". He'll be at a height deficit. He'll be giving up about 5 inches to Washington. He also said, listen, I'm tired of these guys using me as a measuring stick for these top prospects.
You're not going to be a stepping stone for Amir Mansour. Not until I say so. Nobody's going to be a stepping stone for me. Nobody's going to defeat me in this ring. They're going to be very surprised if they think that this is a stepping stone for their fighter. That's just unbelievable. We're really surprised that this guy even took the fight.
Quick thought on our main event.
Well, I look forward to it. You know, it's again, like we talked about earlier in the show, a step up for Gerald Washington. Mansour is not an easy guy to deal with. A rough guy, punching power, a physical kind of opponent. And speaking of physical, this fight's becoming more and more physical because without the jab, you end up with just inside fighting.
Elbiali coming out more on the attack here in round five. We've come to the halfway point of this fight. Uppercut there by Elbiali.
Coming straight in with his hands down. If he's going to move up the ladder, they're going to have a lot of corrections to do because he's quite reckless right now, and he's being anonymous with his knockout records, and he's not developing like he should. He has to settle down, learn how to box, learn how to set up these knockouts as he goes up the ladder. Everybody won't fall just because you hit him.
Oh, here's a right hand.
And it was a straight one.
Yes.
Doesn't seem to have the same effect now that we're in the fifth round, does it?
But at least the accuracy is there when he throws them correctly, you know?
Hilario really needs to start showing his jab, and I think he'd be more successful.
That's the problem. Neither of these guys have really shown much of a jab.
He's scrappy.
They're not on speaking terms with their jabs tonight.
That's for sure. Let him go. Don't need me. Let him go. Stop.
That's funny.
What are you doing? Fox.
Halfway through round five.
Come here. Don't push his head. You pick it up. Let's go. You're holding him. Let him out.
Lario's done a lot of holding.
And the thing about Hilario, you know, some guys, you just throw your bombs at them and eventually they fall. Hilario's obviously not going to be one of those guys. So it's important for Elbiali, he's going to get the stop, to try to think his way through this and start setting traps and start figuring out ways to open up the defense of Hilario. And by loading up constantly, it's going to make that a lot more difficult.
You know, one thing is I watch Hilario's movement. It's no rhyme or rhythm to the movement. And sometimes he looks off balance, too, when he moves.
He's very off balance. And the reason why is he's taking his head off of Elbiali. He's taking his eyes off of him. So once you take your eyes off the opponent, it throws your body off balance. You have to keep your eyes on your opponent in order to stay on balance.
Final 20 seconds here, round five. Mario again with the hold.
Step back. Let's go. Step back. No more of that's going to cost you a point.
You heard Pat Russell admonishing him one more time. He's going to take a point away.
Time, no punches.
Trainer Carlos Alborne there with Ahmed Elbiali. Right before we came back, he was telling, listen, you got a jab to the face, jab to the body, jab to the face. He wants his jab to be on speaking terms tonight.
Well, as a trainer, he's saying the right thing with the jab. I mean, it's got to start with the jab because obviously all these power shots, if you're not setting them up, they're either being blocked or they're being missed.
There's a jab by Hilario.
Step back. Don't hold inside.
Hilario making his U.S. debut here tonight.
Three hands, let him go.
Well, I imagine there's going to be a lot of fighters who thought twice about fighting Elbiali is going to be willing to take him on now if they're watching this fight. And it's not that he can't be a world champion one day. He's just showing a lot of growth flaws, thinking that he can knock everybody out that he faces.
Absolutely, and that's the thing. You know, these are the kind of fights that you have in your career. Again, the word progression that, you know, they show you what you need to work on, what
exactly.
You need, the things that you maybe the flaws you
time.
Have that you can go back
here.
In the gym. Correct.
1 point for holding.
Here's the point being taken away for holding.
1 point for holding. No more. Holding. Time in. Box.
Pat Russell warned him in round five.
It was a fair point taken. He warned him twice. Wally, I think Elbiali's kind of stepped off the gas a little bit. What do you think? You think it's fatigue, or do you think that?
I think it's a little bit of fatigue and a little bit of kind of not knowing what to do. You know, I mean, if you're not going to use the jab, it's not going to give you many options except to keep doing what you're doing.
Stop. Right now, go.
And what he's doing is not getting the knockout, but it is winning them rounds.
But he's smothering his work by not using the jab.
Of course, and he's lucky. Hilario also is a limited variety of opponent because there are things that Elbiali could be paying for worse off.
And he talked to us in the fighting room. He said, I need to perfect this jab. And it's something that you pointed out here tonight.
Well, it's one thing to say it, and it's another thing when you're in the heat of battle. A lot of times, you know, it's harder to think your way through certain moments in certain situations. You know, sometimes confusion just clutters your mind when you're in the fight, and you're not thinking as clearly as you should. And right now, Elbiali, even though he's winning, clearly there is some frustration there because he's not thinking his way through things.
Many fights where he's needed the jab, and it's one thing to talk about it, it's another thing to drill it. Now that's a nice jab, and Hilario should use this jab more because Elbiali is open for the jab. He's coming right into the line of fire, putting his head right in the mouth of the cannon, and the gun should roll.
Yep, exactly. No head movement on the part of Elbiali.
At all.
A guy that jabs may give him even more trouble.
Free hands, got a free hand, good.
Which is another reason why he should be the one jabbing, because, you know, you can jab with a jabber, exactly. You don't hook with a hooker. He can actually hook with anyone because of his powerful hook.
There was a left hook to the body by Elbiali.
First thing they should correct is him walking to the opponent with his hands in a prayer position, pressing both his knuckles together, tipping off what he wants to do. And Hilario's picking up on it.
Stop at the bell. I got it. Let the hands go. Let him go. Stop at the bell, Ahmed. Time, corners.
Well, when we come back, Elbiali will go 7 rounds for the first time. 12 wins, 11 have come by knockout. 7 of those knockouts come in the first round. Well, he's about to go 7 rounds for the first time in his career. You know, the one interesting thing is you take a look at Mariano Hilario. Pat Russell, right at the bell, went to the doctor and said, I think I might want you to come take a look. I think Hilario's getting exhausted. Went to the corner of Hilario and asked him, listen, are you tired? Are you fatigued? Are you exhausted? And Hilario told him, said, no. I want to continue fighting. Let's take a look at the total punches thrown here through round 6. Elbiali has landed 130 of them as he pounds the body of Hilario.
Hilario's looking for the left hook right over the top. Elbiali's off balance when he's in there. He's punching well, but he's not getting the full leverage on the punches because he's falling forward with the punches. He needs to be a little bit more in his legs and stab. He needs to step over and get those punches and not just stand stationary in there. He's leaving himself open to be counted. Anytime his head has ended up on the right shoulder, and if Hilario has any knowledge of how to pull that shoulder, that head back and that shoulder back, he'll catch him with a hook.
You know, we've put together, tabulated all of your scorecards so far that you've sent in as these two fight in the corners. We take a look, compile the numbers and what you guys, the fans, say. And again, you've got Elbiali pitching a shutout. Again, you took away a point there from holding in the last round. 60-53 is what you guys have here thus far.
And watch when Elbiali goes underneath with the left. Watch where his right hand is. I don't know if Hilario sees that. But when Hilario goes to his left, Hilario needs to slip to his left and turn the hook.
He's also just smothered himself. I mean, Elbiali's the one with his back to the center of the ring, so he can create his own punch at home. And he's not.
That's the first time he moved his feet, though. But
he's getting too close when Hilario's against the ropes and smothering his own work.
He is.
All right, I got it. Watch his head. Don't scuff him.
If he would take a step over along the ropes, good jab. If he would take a step over, that hook would be right there because Elbiali is going down low. He does not see Hilario's left hand when they're in close.
Oh, good big shot.
I won't hurt him.
And Hilario grabs Elbiali.
Let him go.
He may be ready.
Stop. Come here. Turn around. Break. Now go.
trainer of Elbiali says, go after him.
But again, it's the same mistake he was making all night.
Smothering his work.
Shot. Smothering his work.
Good shot by Hilario.
Hilario fends him off with a combination. And a right hand. And he survives the round.
Come on. Clear. You win clear the fight. You win clear, super clear. But this guy is not pretending a round with you. He's super tired. How you feel? Give me a beat. Give me a beat.
All right. Touch him up before we start, all right? Clean it up.
That's wrong. All right? You never fight a round. I'll give you a knockout. All right? Be careful with him. He'll give you a knockout. He's tired. You understand to me? How you feel?
Good. Come on.
Well, you heard his trainer, Al Bornay. Listen, he's super tired. You're winning the fight, clearly. Just be careful.
Yeah, I mean, but he's not giving him the valid instructions he needs. He's worried about Hilario catching him with the errant punch. So I think he just wants to get him through this round and get the fight over with, because he said the guy is fighting stupid. But I would have liked to hear him say, look, why don't you work behind your jab more this round and bring your punches off this jab, bring your punches off the jab this round, and let's see what happens. No clear-cut instructions for the offense. It seems like they're looking just to get the fight over with.
It's good. I think it's a good thing, though, that he's got these rounds, and he can now see, he and his team can now see and measure as far as what they need to work on in the gym and assess the performance and get back to work, you know, because early on with all the early knockouts he was having, you know, it's easy to get into that false sense of security. And clearly by the decision making he has made, decisions he's made in this fight, he clearly had that false sense of security. And
you wonder about Elbiali's mental state. You wonder if, since Hilario didn't go down, how he feels about this fight going eight rounds. But I'll tell you, what he needs to work on, his future opponents are going to be working on him too. Now he's on TV, he's on tape, and there are going to be plans put together for him.
Well, Elbiali wanted to go rounds. He's getting rounds here.
And this is not necessarily a bad thing.
Yeah. You know, learning experience.
Prospects, you know, they have to learn and they have to mature, and there's growing stages, and this is a growing fight.
Well, no doubt he's a good prospect. You hope to see him develop as the months and years go by.
One thing his corner told us in the fight, they'd like to see him go down to 168. What do you think? Is that wise choice for Elbiali instead of staying light heavy?
Well, if it doesn't drain him or make him weak, then he should go down to the best fighting weight for him. That could be a factor also. To look at his body, he seems like a solid light heavyweight.
But regardless of what weight he fights at, these are still things he's going to have to correct.
Yeah.
And of course, this fight is going to be the learning curve, so to speak. You know, you can go back to the gym and work on all of these things, you know. And I also don't like the way he crosses his feet every second, too. You know, there's little fundamental mistakes in there, you know.
Under a minute here in this fight.
Step out.
Here's a right by Elbiali.
Stop. Step out.
30 seconds left in this fight.
Last seconds. Let's go. Free hands. Got those free hands. Let him go.
Elbiali should be stepping over right now instead of standing over the top of Hilario. But again, in the sport of boxing, when you got heavy hands, it's worth a go.
Again, the same thing. Cut distance, no jab, overhand right. Cutting this is the same way every time. Look, go down there, overhand right, no jab.
Well, Elbiali goes the distance. Just the second time. When we come back, the judge's official decision. You're watching Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Welcome back. You're watching Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Ahmed Elbiali, Mariano Hilario. Let's take a look at the punch stats. Elbiali threw nearly 500 punches, landed 37% of those punches, as Hilario landed just 90 of his 369 punches. Well, the judge's official decision is in. Let's find out who won this fight. Here's Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, after eight rounds, we go to the scorecards. Here are your score totals. Judge at ringside, Steve Morrow, sees the contest 78-73. And judges Jack Reese and Adelaide Bird are in the coordinates 80-71. All for your winner by unanimous decision and remaining undefeated, Ahmed Elbiali.
Well, no surprise, as Ahmed Elbiali wins the unanimous decision, his record remains unblemished at 13-0, now with 11 knockouts. When we come back, our main event. It's the PBC here on FS1.